down, will you?
I love making new friends.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson, to settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Are you ready to learn how to herd some cows? Thank you for telling me all that back there. It must have been hard for you.
Hope you understand now why I've been playing my cards somewhat close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked. They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
Good to see you, Miss McFarland.
Control that horse, will you? Get behind the herd. That should start them moving in the right direction. Assuming they aren't put off by your smell.
Yeah.
Nice job.
Stay behind them, Mr. Marston.
That's it.
Whoa there.
He's got it. Drive them down the road, Mr. Marston.
Good job.
Easy.
Either that, or you were a cow in a past life.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
I'll see you later. I have work to do back at the ranch.
There you are.
If you're game, maybe you'd like to earn a little something searching aroundabouts for a few plants I'm light on. Here's the deal. Whichever one of us gets back here first with the right plants wins on the bet.
All right, you're on.
Thank you.
This looks like one. So long. Let's go.
Well, hello.
Hello, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarland.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. And we had outlaws, and we had drought, and we had smallpox, and terrible winters. Cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson is a menace, and men like him are the plague. But isn't a government agent a worse menace? And all that symbolizes, I mean.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. But you tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. Sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie. We got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime. Apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on. I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston. Right, now you got some rope on your belt. Let's see if we can't wrangle some horses.
You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
Ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshall got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret who sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches would steal a coin off a dead man's eye.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics,
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy the ride?
I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. And there are few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better, if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland.
Marston, these are fine horses.
Hey, Bonnie, Amos was saying some horses been spotted somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We can really do with those horses. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's head for Armadillo.
Let's go. You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure ask a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a kid.
The fact that you're talking in the past says it all.
No, that's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Sell them, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little, well, you know, countrified.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarland?
From a couple of cheap governesses Pa hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes, that's all. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He'd never admit it, but my Pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarland.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much.
It's kind of painful, but she's never far from my thoughts.
Looks like the ranch hand's up ahead.
That's it! Come on!